Well, it smells like Friday
because I have lots of alcohol on here. Mm. We are with Aaron Colby Begovich today.
Correct.
Hyphenated name.
Hyphenated, honey.
It was a lot for me to figure out before the show started. Like, what is your name?
The only complex thing about me.
Oh, well, then that should be, it should be real easy to get through this interview today then. So, no, because we were talking top of show about hyphenated names. So I am engaged. I will be married on March 18th.
Congratulations.
Oh, hi, Jason. Thank you for my UPS man shirt today. I know Miley had to add some bronzer to me so I didn't look like I was delivering your packages. Delivering
packages,
a package.
Honey.
Hi. We're knocking knees under the chairs because
yes,
that's how close
are.
You have to be on our show. Right? Mm-hmm. I know. Andy's looking out there. He knows. So Aaron's hyphenated because...
No, Aaron's not hyphenated.
Well, not me. No.
It's just Aaron. Colby Begovich.
We toyed around with his name on the lower third of the screen there. Lower third. Because, you know, hyphenated names can be challenging.
They are very challenging.
Tell me, is this something I should take on? The Krausman Kleiber. It's a very long name. Will it even fit in like lines?
Kleiber?
Kleiber is his last name. Mine is Krausman.
I would say Kleiber is a little bit easier than Begovich. And I, like, as I was saying before, like...
That's your husband's last name?
Begovich.
Yeah, gotcha.
Croatian. if you go with Colby Smith,
yeah.
Colby Andrews, but no, Begovich. So
Begovich.
Like getting a hotel room online now or like on the phone, it was 2 minutes before and now yeah. it's about 15 minutes with
yeah.
just the name.
Yeah.
And then
you lose your
there,
place in line on like Ticketmaster.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I can't spell it.
And it doesn't
enough.
Fit. So it's
yeah.
usually like Colby Beg...
Yeah.
Or Colby Bego.
Yeah.
In which, yes.
Yeah, so when they answer the phone at the hotel, like, thank you for calling us, yeah. Mr. Colby Bego.
Yeah. We did it out of love, but
yeah.
now it's kind of time to go back.
Well, I mean, and especially for you being a performer, I mean, that's your,
oh,
this is your stage
gosh.
Name. Now you have a hyphen.
Oh, but that's my stage name is still Aaron Andrew Colby. There's no
oh, okay.
Begovich
oh.
in there.
Aaron Andrew Colby.
Yeah.
He still goes by three names.
Because three names is how you, that's what famous people have. Or serial killers.
Yeah. He could be one of those too, ladies and gentlemen. I don't yet know because I haven't explored all about Aaron today. I'm going to call you Aaron CB. How's that?
I like that.
Okay,
kind of sounds like an STD, but we can do that.
I have a test for you at the lower third. We just learned this phrase about the lower third. I didn't know that in
it's
TV.
Fancy.
It's a lower third.
We just got educated.
We got educated. Scott educated
Thank
us.
Thank you, Scott.
Thank you, Scott. Is the Republican in him? He wants to educate us. I know. I knew I'd go there.
Thanks, Scott,
well,
for everything you've
yeah,
done for
exactly,
us this
I
year.
Know, I know.
Cheers to Scott.
Cheers to Scott. What?
Thanks. Colby Begovich might change, not by my choice.
You could say that so fast. I think he obviously, you're so used to it, so that's
I practiced.
Yeah, I know. I don't think I see Bryce KK sounds kind of scary.
It sounds very Republican.
You know, I very much so,
yeah.
right? So I'm kind of
just
a little at a loss. I figured if we have children, we're not going to name any of them with a K. Because their name will be triple K.
And
I'm not going to say the three others
and
together.
That sounds like a very Kardashian thing.
I know. You're right. Actually, I should do that and rather than think of the white supremacist group out there. Yeah.
And that's the new argument we're having because we're actually yeah. in the realm of adoption right now.
Oh, okay.
And I was fighting yeah. for no middle name because like,
yeah,
they're already getting made fun of for having
oh
two
God.
Amazing dads. But like having 15 names, come on.
They're not even going to be able to spell that in kindergarten.
No. And
they're going to get kicked out.
Out.
That's a lot of that's
no
a lot of
rope.
Names. Yeah, that's a lot of names.
It is.
Well, hi.
Hi.
We've never informally had this time together.
Never.
I'm so glad we have this time together. Am I allowed to sing that without paying Carol Burnett?
Okay.
So, you know, one thing we usually cover at the show is kind of what the week in review we've done and just sort of kind of download some of the things that we're doing or going to be doing. And you can give commentary. It's fine. You know, one thing we were talking about this morning, or actually, was it this morning or yesterday morning? That Kelly, Live with Kelly, you know,
mm-hmm.
she's been live with Kelly for
she's a single lady.
Yes, she's single now. Because I think they're doing really well just having guests
mm-hmm.
whenever they want. She doesn't have to actually commit to anybody. She just has, she doesn't have to be hyphenated.
She's a gay
she's
man.
Just, yeah. He said, Aaron said it with the hyphen. He said it.
With the hyphen. Huh?
He said it. He's, yeah. So I think they have fun with really picking these random people. That she
yeah.
gets to have on the show all the time. So we look at it from the angle, and this is what we did. We did last week, we did our 50th show live from the space, from Mark Chinook Space. That was a trip and a half. If you watched last week, that was insane. We have some footage. Well, that's Naomi Morrow and our wonderful band back there.
She's amazing.
Led by Vince Verderame in the back on the drums. She's awesome.
Is that leopard or cheetah I see?
It just keeps moving
it's
back and
tell.
Forth, you
it's
know.
Just very, it might just be black.
Yeah, I don't know. The lighting was really interesting there, so... We all had this sort of glow, like we were skeletons almost. The skeletons. Her pants were awesome. Yeah, no, we started with Twerk, the new musical. There you go. Awesome,
yes.
Girls. Oh my God.
Oh, Anne Martinez and April.
There we go.
That's exactly what my
I gave Scott
like.
A few shots. He obviously went for the booty
he
shots.
He went online and pulled more up.
Yeah, he pulled more of those.
My abs.
Look at her legs.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my God. Wow.
That's how I feel.
She's hyphenated up there.
She is hyphenating her ass off.
She's hyphenating.
And there you are.
And there I am with my
love your pants too, honey.
They were really tight that day. They were really tight. And with me with Anne. And then we had also, there's me and Vince. I know. Thank you, Maggie, for letting me love on Vince.
That's really nice.
I know. Vince is awesome. And then Enoch, of course, who just can't stop giving wet spots.
I love Enoch.
I know. He's fun.
I love when he calls out mostly, but I love him.
We'll talk about why that is. There was Nikki Scalera, and she talked a little about her Bassy show, and then Travis Klor. Almost closed this out. And then Amy Guest, who just her EP, which I'll give you a copy of. Her EP is called 10 Times Out of 10. And there's you attempting to mount me.
That's nice.
Everyone was doing that to me. I don't know if I was inviting this.
Well, you're shimmying in this one.
I know I was, yeah. Look at my stomach. God help me. and that tattered old chair that he had there that he stole from a Goodwill. We had Amy on it. Amy's EP is called 10 Times Out of 10. In fact, I think she just launched a video that she shot at the Artisan Hotel.
Okay.
Yeah, I love that
She's
face.
Beautiful.
She's stunning. And she has quite a following now. You won't find out for 30 days after your album comes out, but she keeps getting put on like the hot list of popular songs. If you go on iTunes for pop music, her EP comes up all the time. So it's pretty exciting for her. So I'm excited for her. She already has people, like young girls, sending her videos of them redoing her song and stuff. So, you know, she's,
I love that.
Yeah, she's on her. But we gave one away to everyone in the audience. I felt a little like Ellen.
Oh, you get away.
You get one. Yes.
It's good that we don't have a lot of good singers left in the world right now. So it's nice that we're coming back to that.
Well, and she wrote all her own music too. So she had, and then her husband, they both started the record label, Stiff Records. Hyphenated, Stiff Record. I know.
Hyphenated,
Stiff Hyphen. And he's playing some right now.
Give it to us.
I think so. I don't. Is it Amy Guest? Did you look up a different person with a T or SS? SS. God, I don't recognize this one. It might have been an old one she did. Oh, that's there you go. This is 10 Times Out of 10. And she shot this video here in town too. She's pretty awesome. But yeah, she just shot a video at the Artisan, and they did that. They I think they air that today. She did a remake of Metallica's Enter Sandman.
I don't know Metallica that well, but that's one of the one songs I do know.
That's the one song I don't know.
That takes talent.
Yeah. We'll have to play that after the show. So
thank you, Amy, for your talent.
Thank you so much, darling. Hope you're watching, but she sleeps till noon. So she
will. Most of us do.
She might catch it at the very beginning of the show.
Most of us do.
But we did lose a powerhouse in Vegas this week. We lost Tony Saka. Entertainment, Las Vegas style. And that's honestly, as we've patterned the show, I got goosebumps. As we patterned the show, you know, he's been doing his show for a long time. He's been in the entertainment business for 30 years, came from Philadelphia. He called Vegas his home, but he never tired of the business he was in. And I think this is something we were talking about at the office yesterday for him was, you know, here's a man who, you know, a lot of people do multiple jobs or multiple kinds of jobs. And I have a lot of you guys on, and this is number 51. Yeah, Aaron's number 51. I'm very tired at 51.
Thank you.
It was like that Aaron Brockovich line. 50 blowjobs in 6 days. I'm very tired. Sorry, everyone. Especially in the middle of Tony's thing. That wasn't very nice. But he'd get a laugh out of that. No, he stuck to his craft. He stuck to what he was doing. He had his show. And actually, I didn't know this before, but he had a twin brother. And his twin brother passed away almost 18 years ago. But they did entertainment together. They even did a stint I read that David Letterman had them do when he was in town, where they kind of interviewed two different people, kind of like dueling interviews because they were twins. And so, but he really stayed true to what he was doing in this town and really made a name for himself. So they're having a celebration of his life tomorrow at the Stratosphere. No, not tomorrow. Today is only Friday. Monday. At the Stratosphere.
Well, cheers to Tony.
Cheers to Tony. Thanks for paving the way for us.
The original Donnie and Marie. I love that. Siblings.
Oh, my God. This is how it goes. This is what's going to happen today. And then on top of that, this is something.
Ooh,
oh,
that good
well, now we're
guy.
On to the Aaron CB.
And, oh,
Aaron CB. CB's done. He's already popping the CB cherry. So that's your headshot, I think.
That probably is my headshot. Yeah,
it's a very nice headshot.
Thank you.
Yeah, look at your piercing eyes.
Thank you.
And you matched your shirt.
That's weird how that happened.
So nice how you did that. Wow.
Thank you. Like 98% of my wardrobe is blue.
Are my eyes brown?
They look exactly
brown today?
UPS eyes.
Okay. I deliver on time. I deliver your package.
Packages are never late.
No. Ever. Your knee keeps knocking me.
Sorry.
It's okay.
So close.
It's the can-can. So when you alluded to it a minute ago, you talked about you love when Enoch calls out because Aaron plays him in Zombie Burlesque when Enoch is out.
Correct.
With his wet spots. He's out. Bye, Enoch. I think Enoch, so you kind of do a little Tonya Harding on Enoch sometimes.
Sometimes,
right?
A little bit of drop some pearls, really, a little shove.
Really want to be on the show.
I do.
That show is really fun.
It really is.
You play in the show as well, his role?
No, I'm just a call-in suite.
Okay,
yeah.
Just a call. Sometimes I just call into my show too. He does an amazing job, but that show, I said this, I think we talked about this last week on the show, was that... it has like the number one rating on TripAdvisor. Like you guys have done a really good job of promoting the show.
Oh, David Sachs. That's the one thing
he's fantastic at that. But the show itself, I love the theater. Mm-hmm. I love the layout of the theater. I love how close you are to the performers. I mean, it's so much fun.
It's almost too close.
It's so much fun. Well, I think we sat in like the third row and there's, you know, definitely dildos hitting your face.
Yes.
And
lots
of dildos. Actually, we didn't bring one on today. Where's our props?
I've got two in my car. Sorry.
Two for the hyphen. And I bet you get compliments on the hyphen, right?
Always. Mm-hmm. But no, it's the show is great in the fact that it's different every night.
Yeah.
And it's also like when I'm in, there's another swing as well. Mm-hmm. Whenever Jesse's in, the show is completely different. So even if you've seen it one night and then you come the next night, it's gonna always be
I gotta come
show.
See it with you in it.
Please do.
Yeah.
If Enoch will call out,
tired
Enoch.
Of Enoch. I'm
615-516-5563.
Call
me.
The number now. Call now.
Call me.
Call now and demand with your senator, demand that Aaron be on.
Just one night.
Flood the lines. Just one night. But you are also, and we'll kind of like go backwards in time and then forwards kind of thing. Because, you know, we just don't do anything in any order here at the show.
Best.
It is better that way. Because magic happens when you're
just
not
let it
in
flow.
Order. Aaron has been in a couple of our set list shows. I was not aware of all of them. You were definitely in American Idiot, which we might have to be reprised here.
Because
we were all caught unawares that night, the four.
That's
so
it
I
came
think
together.
The Idiot showed back up somewhere, so we kind of, you know, can revamp that. Oh, we got commentary from Scott that you can't hear, but we're not going to repeat that word. It's Republican language. Fuckery.
No.
It's not. It's not going well. Understatement of the world. But yeah, so we did that. We did that show. And then you were also in our
Van Halen
show.
That was.
So did you do 1984 or did you do...
I was a background vocalist with Francesca, so I got to do the whole kit.
Yeah, you did.
Just scream and yell and have some fun. And we get to have our lyrics too. That's the best part of being a background vocalist.
When we were doing our 50th show last week, we were kind of like reminiscing through some of the old shows. And yeah, when we had... Sarah Hester Ross on the show at that time, right after the Van Halen show, with my uncle who worked for Van Halen for a short time.
Wicked.
Yeah, he ended up giving me, which I wish I still had, as I'm looking for things that I find in basements. I had lots of Van Halen. That sounded really
looking
weird.
For. I was looking just that's where I was stuck. For
that sounded
a
very torturous. we have basements. Yeah, there's me on my cell phone.
You look great.
Probably quoting something. Yeah, that was a nice shirt. We talked about the fact that, you know, in that particular show that we did, I mean, there was so much irreverence, but the music core of it, I mean, we had the best band in that show. I think, what was his name? Who played guitar. I mean, he was so amazing.
He was amazing.
He had a hyphenated name too, I think.
And he was really, I got to actually hold his guitar while he played it at one point.
Of course you did.
Because he couldn't do it all at once. I'm really good at holding a lot of things and doing a lot of things.
He's magically holding my knee under his knee.
I've got three knees. Whoa, wait.
It's the bottom third.
Oh, gosh.
The lower third.
Lower third.
It's the lower third today.
Sorry, Mom. That wasn't appropriate.
Where's Mom watching from?
She's not watching. She lives in the UK, actually.
Oh.
She married.
We don't stream in the UK.
Mate. She's mate with Australia. She's married a
British
guy.
It's on 8 o'clock in
the UK. 8 o'clock, mate. She's asleep.
She's sleeping at 8 o'clock?
She's a preacher's wife, so she's very
She's
sleepy.
With a mate, you said?
No, she married a Brit.
Oh, she married a Brit.
Yeah, actually from the Isle of Man.
So she is...
Oh.
And then we randomly go. There she is right now. Hi,
she's wearing
Mom.
Heavy makeup for this.
Hi, Mom.
That's actually my makeup for Zombie.
Right, right. With open
with a deep
shirt.
V.
The deep V.
Deepest of Vs.
It looks like Mormon underwear.
It is.
Almost. Okay.
But
is
the
it?
The thing for me at the show is I'm in the show so rarely, which is great because Enoch is consistently on.
Right.
That
he's
I,
always on, honey. He's always on.
It takes me longer to do the makeup than to actually do the show.
Gotcha.
It takes about an hour and a half.
Could you put on prosthetics too?
I got it all on.
You have everything on.
Yeah.
You need help. You need help on the lower third for the show.
Yeah, lower third.
There's a lot of activity going on there. Now tell me about this show, because I was trying to, I feel like I saw this.
That show was called My Wedding.
I did not see that. Is this the hyphenated Begovich individual?
They asked, you guys asked for pictures, and so I just went, there's some really good ones in here.
Did I see a picture of two dogs?
There is a picture of two dogs.
Okay, I'm making sure I saw.
That's from Monday's Dark.
That's not your husband.
No,
that's Justin Rodriguez.
That's Justin
Rodriguez. Justin Michael Rodriguez.
Yeah, he's like one of my best buddies. We've actually followed each other from show to show. We both started in the Shames show at Treasure Island and ended up
at
Spoofical, the musical.
This is you playing Caitlyn Jenner.
That's me playing Caitlyn Jenner.
with your gold medal.
Doesn't my hair
which
look
like a Bruce Jenner?
Amazing.
Your eyes, I just can't get over your
it's
eyes
a proud
right now.
Moment. My father was very
is that
proud.
When you got your ESPY award? Is that looks a lot ESPY like happened. Her ESPY acceptance speech.
That was,
for
same
sure.
dress and all. This is from Zombie. This is
and
the opening
April.
Number.
Oh my God.
April with that body. And Sophia, Talia, Mandy.
Those
and yeah, that's
awesome
me
dancers.
Doing a little hip action.
Yeah.
That's and actually from American Idiot.
Yeah, that is. Richard Brisky. He takes great photos.
He takes amazing
photos. He did the photos.
Photos
we just did for the 50th show. So
I love that.
He focused on butts on that one, clearly.
That's
so.
A good
and
ask.
Are you doing some
this
sort
is
of,
actually, yeah. I was on cruise ships for almost 10 years, and that's me
there we go.
On my cruise ship.
This is the cruise ship show. I know.
I found when I moved here.
He's such an ass back there.
He is. He's an ass.
He's an ass clown. Thank you, Scott. Thank you.
But you found
I did give him a present. I can always take it back today. He heard my first. People can hear that now. He's in our ear. People can hear you.
The thing, though, is when I moved here from, I lived in New York for a long time.
Yeah.
When I moved here, almost, I went to see Vegas, the show. That was the
yes.
first show I saw. And
yeah.
about 98% of those people are from cruise ships.
Yeah.
And so I felt like I was back on a cruise ship. And it's so
that
great to see
amazing.
That people can transition out of
that
cruise
you can,
life.
You can transition out of cruising.
Yes.
And become
cruising.
Hyphenated. There
and
is hope
hyphies.
For you to become
there
hyphenated.
There is hope.
Yeah. There's hope for you.
There is hope.
Getting off
as long
the
as you don't marry someone who's an entertainer as well, because then
so
you're
so obviously he's an entertainer then.
He's in the entertainment industry.
What does he do?
He is the director of entertainment operations at Carnival Cruise Lines.
Oh, he's a cruiser.
He's never on the cruise ship.
He's never
now.
On the boat. So he sets it all up from here. That's so fascinating.
He doesn't live here. He lives in Miami.
Oh my God.
He flies home every weekend to here. To
so he's watching 3 o'clock time.
He is. He's actually
Hi.
Watching. I told him to watch. Hi from Miami.
What's his first name?
Joey.
Hi, Joey.
Joey Colby Begovich, hyphenated.
Well, he wouldn't be Begovich Colby?
No, that's not the same last name then. There's no point.
Oh.
You have to be the same name for it to work.
I'm so confused.
Like, we're the Colby Begovich family. There can't be, like, the Colby Begovich Colby family. That doesn't make sense.
Wow. Okay, now I'm really confused. I'm going to have this long discussion
so
with Jason when I get
hyphenate,
home.
You have to choose the same last name. That's the point.
Ooh.
Just like when the woman usually changes her name.
What if you created a name?
You could. Or like a hybrid.
You know.
My dear friends, Carlin. And Allison, hi, my dear friends. She's in Pinup, amazing
okay.
show.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
They're Ward and I can't think. Masson.
Montgomery.
They're the War Zones.
Oh,
so like that's their name.
The War Zones.
The War Zones.
What did you think? What did you say?
Did you say Montgomery?
Well, yeah. those of you watching who have no idea what I said because there's no.
He's
story
losing here. Me too. But anyway, so you can.
How old are you?
There's no. I'm a little older than 30.
Okay.
But the good thing is, like, until well. We used to have freedom to do whatever we wanted until certain
know,
things happened.
Yeah,
thank you,
fuck
Scott.
That.
Oh,
he wrote his name in on the line.
Vote for Scott.
Vote for Scott for your lower third.
So anyway, it's you can do whatever
you
want.
Hey,
thank you for that, Scott.
Hey.
Thank you.
I love you, Scott.
We're just steps away from his tower too. Scott's tower.
You know
those, and Trump's
I know.
Tower.
Do you know we were just talking about this last night because where was I at? I forgot. But we were talking about. I said I wake up every morning. Out my window is the Trump Tower. That's what I see when I wake up
Isn't
in the morning.
Isn't that great?
So
it's refreshing.
It's a reminder every day.
Don't be yourself.
Don't be yourself. Never be yourself.
I like
Always
that.
Be someone else.
Always be exactly
It'll be huge.
What someone
It'll be
else
huge.
It's great.
For sure.
It's
I said I wasn't going to do any impressionated thing because I don't like him. So I don't know if they'll let anyone in from that country. sorry. Pardon everyone. And back to zero. What were we talking about? We were talking about Montgomery Ward.
We
it's hyphenated names.
Hyphenated names.
Made up names. So your friends are called the War Zones.
Yeah, the War Zones.
So mine is Krausman Kleiber. We could be...
Krober.
Krober.
No.
Krobar? That's a gay
crowbar.
Bryce Crowbar.
In Miami, isn't it? Crowbar?
Yeah, yeah, there's a crowbar.
The
there was a crowbar
to.
Somewhere here in Seattle. I don't remember.
We're here in
I feel like I went,
in Seattle.
When I lived in... Oh my God, I'm so confused.
We're in a destination
That's
shoot
the rub
right
today.
Now.
We are. We're on our cruise.
We are on a
we're
cruise.
We're on a cruise right now Vacation to cruise. Seattle. Oh, look at him trying to direct me again. Oh. I thought he was giving up on me.
Are we losing focus? Sorry.
Focus. We do that a lot.
Losing focus.
So you came from New York... By yes. way of New York, originally from...
Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Oh, my God.
Republicans everywhere.
That's okay.
That's why I was Republican.
They're changing.
Thanks, Dad.
They're changing.
They are
changing. Is Dad still in Oklahoma?
Dad is in Oklahoma.
Okay. And Mom is in Britain.
In Britain, yeah. Both remarried.
She did a Brexit.
She
Brexited. She Brexited the U.S. for a Britain man.
But cool story. Like, my mom wasn't... People say, oh, she's so far away. She originally was living in mid-country Africa.
Oh, wow.
As a missionary.
Oh, wow.
So she's actually closer. Well, now that she's
yeah,
in England.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
She's just a hop skip.
Wow. So how did she end up in Tulsa, Oklahoma?
Well, she was from Texas.
Okay.
She went to school at Oral Roberts. Funny name. Oral Roberts University.
I feel like snot's going to come out of my nose any minute.
And that's where she met my dad. And so yeah. She was in Tulsa. They got divorced.
Nope. I'm not going to go. That's too obvious a joke. Yeah. No.
Mr. Oral.
They met at Oral Roberts.
That was his name. Mm-hmm. Oral.
Yeah. I know. Like Oral Hershiser. He's a famous baseball player. Right? I got that right.
So manly.
I know. Look, and you know, the biggest fucking game of the world happens on, I give two shits about that thing. But I do hope for the Atlanta Falcons to win.
The Super Bowl. We've moved to the Super
yeah,
Bowl.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Whatever. It's fine.
Great party.
I know.
Great halftime show. Lady Gaga.
Yeah. I know. It should be real interesting. So see, snot's coming out of my nose.
That's lovely. You
Sorry.
Look great, though.
Oh, thank you. That would be Miley. She made me look good today.
She's beautiful.
Where were, Tulsa. She's gorgeous. Yeah. She's beautiful.
So anyway, she went to Tulsa. Then she became a missionary, lived in Africa. Then she met.
So did you leave your husband? Did you leave your dad and move to mission to be a missionary?
No, they were divorced
they
for
together?
Years since I was a small child.
Okay.
Then she moved there. And then she was like, I'm done. I'm going to just serve the Lord.
Wow.
And then when she finally said that, she met Eddie, my stepdad. And
who's a Brit?
Who's a Brit,
right.
A British pastor. And
wow.
And she lives in the UK. It's so weird. And
that's so awesome.
And they're doing so
Do
well.
You go often to visit?
I try to. I was on ships for so long, and now that we moved here and jumping from show to show, it's kind of hard to leave.
So when did you come here? What was the year
I
you
moved
came here?
Almost exactly a year and a half ago.
Oh, you're a new transplant.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Yeah, I think aside from somebody we had that's been here 3 weeks, you have,
really
you're cool. You're the shortest time been here guest here.
Oh, that's not.
Well,
I am.
Don't give me your commentary,
That's why
Scott.
I can't get
it's
much
not
work
nice.
Here. Is my
yeah,
name.
No.
It's
nice
no, but yeah, thank you.
You can't get it because you're hyphenated.
Because I'm hyphenated and really short. No, but no, yeah, we've been here for
so
a while.
So you've only been a year and a half.
Yeah.
That's
been a good year and a half.
Yeah, no, because you've been in our stuff.
Yeah, like, that's when I almost.
He plucks you from the like brand new.
Almost on Broadway, but then I hit that and then I was like, I've climaxed at House Seats Presents. Go wherever you'd like to go with that.
Go
thank you. I opened myself up. Sorry.
Go wherever you want to go with that. He's literally waiting like, you know, like Ellis Island over here to get the few that are allowed in here to get you on our shows. That's awesome.
He's actually really,
Andy's good.
He's a great
Andrew,
guy.
He's so formal. He's calling you Andy. He's because he's hyphenated.
Sorry.
I'm so sorry to Joey and all the work you went through to go hyphenated.
We had to send social security
and probably
security
just
line.
To give it. Yeah, I'm sure, honey.
I just hit your knee again.
I know you did.
It's really soft knee. I like it. I can barely reach the floor right now. I don't know how my knee is going to get me.
Aaron Colby Begovich. He's short.
I am short. I'm a short
okay.
guy. I'm a short guy.
That's all right.
But that's,
you make up for it in your lower third. It's okay. Speaking of set list things, I do need to give a plug. We are doing the Queen. We're doing the music of Queen. We're doing the Queen.
So we're all going to the UK.
Yep. Donald Trump may not be allowed in there, but we're going
we're
to
going.
Meet with the Queen. No, we are doing the music of Queen. We Will Rock You specifically on February 24th, Friday, February 24th.
That will
House
be amazing.
Blues,
I'll definitely be there to see
the
that.
House of Blues. But there are a few more upcoming. There you go again. There are a few more upcoming ones that you might be responsible to be in, as well as. Oh, I know you're going to be contracted in with us, as well as House Seats Presents is sort of taking over direction of Ribbon of Life this year.
What a cool, cool thing.
And Broadway Cares Equity Fights AIDS joint show of Jesus Christ Superstar in April.
That'll be
so
amazing.
There will be auditions forthcoming. We'll talk about it on House Seats Presents Facebook page.
All male leads are already taken, though.
Exactly. Jesus Sorry. Is already Jesus. Accounted for. Jesus.
Jesus and Judas are
Jesus.
Both taken.
Jesus was a hyphenated Sorry. Person.
Jesus.
He was. Jesus. 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 Well, he has a good pedigree because his mom is with a British preacher.
Yeah.
And his dad lives in Oklahoma, so that just puts you right.
I'm very well-rounded.
You are.
That's why I'm going to the gym.
That's why we're going after this with our rum and vodka intake.
Brought to you by Coke Zero.
So tell me, you are now in the reboot, as it were. Lots of things are rebooting. Yes. You're in the reboot of Legends in Concert opening here at the...
Flamingo.
I was going to say the Link. I know that. It's next door.
The Link.
It's next door.
Shh. They are connected.
Settle down, everyone. Settle down.
At Flamingo.
Legends in Concert at Flamingo. Yes. How did this come about for you? And how did you get picked for this?
I actually went to an audition last year, being 2016. They had an open call. And it was one of those mornings where you just don't want to do it. But I said, I'm going to go. Because they're over like in Henderson where the auditions were. And I'm in Summerlin. No thanks.
It's just too far.
Cross country.
Way too far.
Pack a day bag.
Yeah.
And it was a huge audition. And
a lot of people there?
Tons. Yeah. Like you couldn't move. It was like American Idol.
Wow. There you go.
So they had the singers dance first, which I used to dance like in my early 20s, but not anymore. So
Since you became a hyphen, it didn't happen for
me. The hyphen really threw me down.
Yeah.
But the popping and locking that they had us do during the auditions, like there was no pop or lock, maybe some oars, no pop or lock. But then
dirtiest audition I've ever heard of.
I just had so much fun.
Yeah.
And then
you didn't care. It was kind of like,
there was no pressure because there's no way I was going to outdance any of these folks.
Yeah.
And then we got to sing, and that's when I got to show off a bit. And then they hired me.
What did you sing?
I sang Let's Stay Together.
Al Green. I'm so in love with you. I went a little early.
Whatever you want to do. Whatever you want, Bryce.
It's all right with me.
So obviously that's... Yeah,
that was a fun little karaoke.
That was nice. Yeah. Oh, we were almost in the right key.
We were almost in the right key. If it hadn't been for the hyphen, we would have been
The hyphen threw us down.
Oh, yeah.
I'm so black. I'm so in love with
hyphenations.
No. Sad we lost him a while ago.
I know. You know what? And that song, I used to do that song just for karaoke because everyone likes that song.
You can't go wrong
with it.
Well, unless you really suck.
I don't know how much further I could go into that song because I don't really have a high.
Just goes, Yeah. But so luckily they hired me because they don't really hire a lot of background vocalists. It's usually singer-dancers.
Right.
This body doesn't sing and dance. So they hired me for Foxwoods up in Connecticut.
Yeah, yeah.
Did that over the holidays. Background vocalists, and got a call while I was there saying, hey, we're revamping the show. Would you be interested if we actually put the background vocalist part in, which they've not done in over 30 years. It's always been everyone.
That's
everyone
cool.
Dance. So I'm technically the first male background vocalist to ever grace the Flamingo Legends in Concert stage.
That's the audience out there.
And the cast is unbelievable.
I think do we have a photo of any? Not yet.
No, I don't really have photos of it yet.
This show opens when?
Show opens on February 11th.
Oh, we're going to be there. Oh, we're coming.
It's going to be amazing.
It's at the Flamingo.
Yeah, and they really highlight the dancers.
Are you in the showroom that is
Donnie
Marie's showroom?
Yeah.
So he alluded to that earlier on. He knew what he was doing.
I know,
you're so witty.
You. But the acts are amazing.
I've been outwitted on my show already by Aaron CB.
You're on it.
So
but the acts are amazing. They've lowered, because they used to have about five or six acts. Now we're just doing four at a time. And we've got Michael Jackson, Elvis Presley, Marilyn Monroe, and my personal favorite, Janis Joplin.
So you actually have a friend of mine in your show. You have Adria Dunford in your show.
I saw her this morning.
She lives in my building. We are neighbors. I love her. I saw a picture of you with her, I think, either on Facebook or something you might have sent from a different thing.
Yes.
But but I got a chance to see, I see her every day. So
she was my first friends in Vegas at a gig we did.
We're running out of time.
Oh,
how's that possible?
What happened?
I don't like that. I don't like looking down at my phone and it says I'm on a timer.
But come see Legends in Concert. That's the key.
Wow.
February
11th. So February 11th.
10 shows a week.
Oh my God. So two shows nightly. You're dark one day?
We're dark on Fridays.
Okay. You're dark on Fridays.
Good, because I can go to the club and really get
going
on.
So
practice my pop and lock.
Oh my God. Well, I wanted to really fast say something because, my timer's going to go off. I want to turn it off here before I. So you followed your dreams here from Tulsa to New York to cruise ships to meeting Joey, taking on a hyphen. When I was in the basement again of looking for things, I know it's like that movie Split. It's very crazy. I found this. This is something that I was going to kind of pay homage to Tony doing because when I was 12, I think maybe 11 or 12 years old, my mom and I can't figure out, according to Andy, this is the hoary, but it's the worldly. I own a restaurant here in town, BW Bistro. I had tilt it this way. They're back towards me.
You. Like tilt it so the light can hit it.
Towards the light.
There you go.
There we go. Towards the light, Caroline.
Send her up to heaven.
The Worldly Restaurant.
Restaurante.
Yes. It looks like Jack Hay or something. But I have to tell you, first of all, my appetizers on here. First of all, that I had a restaurant when I was 12, right? I had veal sticks.
You were already...
What the hell is a veal stick?
You were fancy then.
I was like, is that meat sticks? I had pate, caviar.
Poo-poo platter.
Poo-poo platters, because it was very Hawaiian.
Very Hawaiian.
But then I had things like egg foo young and mugu gai pan. Like, I'd never eaten at an Asian restaurant before. But I have... where's the really funny one that's in here? Okay, so I have all this different thing. Then I have random build-your-own tostada. Sushi, because that was the most expensive thing on the item, $45.95.
You have prices and everything.
I had Puerto Rican rum, spelled P-O-D-E-R-R-I-C-A-N. An old classic French wine for $13. Oh. So, and fortune cookies. But I made a menu and at 12 and never knew that I would be doing this for a living or even where we are in right now. So,
follow
the Friday follow your dreams.
I like that.
I love it.
FFD. Friday follow your dreams.
Hyphenate all of your life.
Hyphenate your life.
Hyphenate all of your life. Love you, Aaron, CB.
Love you, Brad.
Bye. Happy Friday.
Happy Friday.